It is an eye-catching common phenomenon. We can all see most of the vessels in the bulb-like projection fit in the forward end of the ship, usually below the waterline.
Do you know that the exact science of the bulbous bow that you can see on ships today only started getting officially figured out on the 50s and the 60s? But if we want to fully understand the concept, we need first to take some minutes going back in time. Let's start by the 19th century, where William Froude had discovered that one of his models, which was having a blunt end, currently in the Science Museum in London, had more resistance at lower speed, but less resistance at higher speeds compared to a normal hull. And some decades later, Admiral David Watson Taylor of the US Navy, to whom this bulbous bow technology is mostly credited, found through his repeated testing of the ram bow that it had some impact reducing wave-making resistance, which made the invention of the very earlier version of the bulbous bow possible, entering the service in 1910. The exact science of the bulbous bow that you can see on the vessels today in front only started getting officially figured out in the last few decades, thanks to Dr. Takao Inui at the University of Tokyo, who published a paper titled Wave-Making Resistance of Ships in 1962. And it wasn't until 1982, with the implementation of computational fluid dynamics, that bulbous bows started to offer truly significant advantages. But how does the bulbous bow technically actually work? Let's start by taking the case of a regular bow. As the ship is surging forward, the water particles are moving towards the stern, along the entire length of the ship, where a pressure wave builds up at the foremost point of the ship, known as the stagnation point, where water particle velocity is equal to zero. In fact, giving rise to the crest at that exact point increases the drag of the vessel, as well as fuel consumption due to the drag, which results to a major engine power waste. The main purpose of adding the bulbous bow is to manage aligning the throw of the bulb with the crest of the main bow wave, recovering some of the lost energy. As the bulbous bow is sized, shaped, and positioned so as to create a wave system at the bow, which partially cancels out the ship's own bow wave system, the wave-making resistance is therefore also reduced in a Froude number range of 0.175 and 0.7. Moreover, compared to normal bows, bulbous bows can make 12 to 15% fuel efficiency and reduce pitch movement as well as slamming effects in severe seas. Furthermore, as the ship moves forward through the water, the bulbous bow modifies the flow of water around the hull, and therefore, reducing drag also increases speed and stability.
Oui, j'ai réussi, je pense.
C'est incroyable parce que...
Tu penses pas?
Ah si, vous avez réussi, vous avez réussi.
Il y a un doute là-dessus?
Non,
il y a...
However, bulbous bows are not miracle devices, as after repeated model testing procedures, it has been found that they were not efficient at all service speeds. As in very low Froude numbers, they have been found to increase the drag. In fact, they are proven to be more suitable for slow ships with high block coefficient than at fast ships with low block coefficient, like container ships, cruise ships, or even tankers, which means that they cannot be good alternatives for vessels like yachts, high-speed crafts, or small fishing vessels. Although the bulbous bow looks like presenting a small part of the ship, it plays in fact a critical role, asserting itself as an elementary device in practical shipbuilding. And in order to maximize its benefits, correct design guidelines boosted with power predictions is the perfect formula in order to improve ship design, hydrodynamic engineering, and naval profitability. See you on the next video.